white-tipped reef sharks are night hunters. And they are hungry. With snake-like bodies and a collapsible dorsal fin, they're perfectly equipped to squeeze through a labyrinth of tunnels. Scouring the reef, they follow scent trails to locate prey. When they've found a victim, they can be known to work together, trapping exits and shepherding stray fish to their deaths. But for these predators, there's more than one way to catch a fish. If a meal eludes them, they have another sense in reserve. Electroreceptors on their head can detect an animal's bioelectrical energy. Even the tiniest electrical signal, as small as the heartbeat of a frightened fish, will reveal a hiding place. The sharks pass. The parrotfish doesn't move a muscle. Against the super senses of these night stalkers, the parrotfish stood no chance.
He's checking this whale out, and he's gonna eat something soon. Oh, he's going for it, going for it.
Biting with a force of nearly 2 tons per square inch, it saws off hunks of flesh the size of trash cans.
Man!
Look at the power.
He just ripped a hole in the front of that whale.
Then, suddenly, the 18-footer abandons its meal and starts to circle the boat. They don't know what it's doing, but it's coming so close, Gray decides to try and tag it.
All right, baby, come on.
Get him,
Hans. No! No! Right where I want it. Right where I want it. Come on!
It's the fifth great white to join Greg's study. Like Ruthless and Storm, it now carries a satellite tag.
How's that tag look?
Good.
Is it floating?
Yeah, it came right up.
This one's set to release in 8 months, in April of 2011. It'll be the last of Greg's tags to deploy.
2-ton elephant seals are in the water. The conditions are ripe for a deep water attack.
You know, she may be staying deep again because it's so bright, but that's gonna change in the next 15 minutes to a half hour. She's biding her time, you know, just biding her time, hanging deep, waiting for one of these seals to make a mistake.
Nearly invisible. Deep Blue stays down at 300 feet, waiting for a seal to pass overhead. She can see 10 times better than us in low light.
There's an elephant seal up there.
I'm heading to the colony.
That's okay.
If the team is right, Deep Blue will strike as the bulls dive deep and make a run for shore.
Shark cam's right on top of the shark, sun setting behind the mountain. And we're still tracking into the evening here, right into hunting territory. So we're on edge.
Deep Blue stays deep. it's another shark that sneaks in for the attack. A smaller aggressive male tries to stake his claim on the territory.
You don't want to see Shark Cam get hit like that, but at the same time, you know, there's benefits to it. We want to see if these animals are striking vertically at depth, you know. 100, 200, 300 feet down, boom, coming up.
The sharks hide deep, waiting for the seals to arrive. As they dive for shore, the sharks attack vertically, striking at depth. As the body floats to the surface, they feast.